said.
You thought it was over.
You like to be vulnerable, cause I like to love, and I like to love hard.
I wasn't born last night. I know these hoes ain't right. But you was blowing up her phone last night. But she ain't have a ring or not her ring on last night. Ooh.
Vulnerability. Why we need to talk about it? It's something that needs to be talked about. And a lot of times when people love, right? They could
let this be just
have right. Expectations or a certain just perception. Right. See, what I've come to learn is that my reality, you know, you and I may be interacting, but we're still not facing the same reality. Because in my head, it's something completely different. I look at you a certain way, and I draw up this person of who I see you as. And that person I see you as when I come across you is probably much different than how the next person sees you. But see, this is my world and my reality when dealing with you, right? So what happens when that perception of another is shattered during times of vulnerability? What do you do?
You got caught, homie.
It's a very uncomfortable, you know, position to be in. I don't think that's like people wake up in the morning and say, oh my gosh, I just cannot wait to be vulnerable today. So let's talk about it. Let's talk about vulnerability. This is vulnerable for me. I don't know where to start. Okay, I think I figured this out. This is a lot better, ain't it? This is so better. I'm sorry, y'all. I just try to figure out this lighting situation, how I'm going to sit, how I'm going to be comfortable, you know, because, you know, when you're being vulnerable, I don't know if I want to sit in the chair and be vulnerable. I didn't want to sit down and I want to cross my legs. I do that. You know what I mean? It's disappointing. It's like during those times of silence, when you don't hear from that person, when you've reached out, you get these answers that you could have never gotten if there was no silence there. You know, you start thinking and it's connecting the dots to certain things from the past, or like, you'd be like, never in a million years. Like, where did it come from? Then you start questioning, like, well, we've been friends this long. Like, how do you really feel about me then? Because I would never do that to you. You know what I mean? Like, these are just certain expectations, like, and then you realize, okay, we all have limits. We all fall short. But damn. Just place them where you should place them, right? They show you who they are, believe them. Dang, but it took you 14 years to show me that shit. Was any of this genuine at all? Like, it just makes you question, like, your whole reality, because this shit just blew me out of the water. Like, whoa. For the past 3 months, I've been in some vulnerable situations. And here we go again with expectations. I want to point this back out to that moment of silence that people leave you in. You know, those times where you're expecting for someone to catch you, you know, and they don't. And there's that silence. You don't hear from them for a while. That's where you get all your answers. And I've noticed, like, okay, so that situation that I gave y'all very vaguely has happened around when my father passed. Right when my father passed, you know what I mean? I called my friend up, you know, there's never no problem we going down to go visit or whatever. I didn't even want to vent. I just wanted to be around some good energy. You know what I mean? So we were supposed to meet up. I bring my son with me. That's like her little nephew. At, you know what I mean? 14 years, like, she stood us up. I drove an hour or some change to come see her. She never met me. Didn't pick up the phone. Nothing. It's like, the time that I really need her, like, are you fucking kidding me? So I called and I called and I called. She didn't pick up the phone. So I called from my son's phone. All right, so I'm being vulnerable with y'all. I'm sharing stories. Feel me? Because I tell stories. That's what I do. Tell you my story. All right, so call from my son's phone. Right? I've been calling from my phone. Ain't no pickup. Call from my son's phone. Focus on my son. Like, I ain't gonna say no names. I respect the integrity of, like, yeah, people and stuff like that. I'm over this stuff. I'm over it.
Yeah, focus.
I'm just sharing my story. Because we're talking about vulnerability. And me sharing my story is being vulnerable. This is very uncomfortable. You know what I mean? So, just gotta do it. But she picks up the phone and he's like, why you ain't pick up? How come you're not meeting us? She said, because I didn't want to. It was the audacity for me. Because you were so bold to say that to a child. I called you so many times. Damn, I was worried. I thought something was wrong with you. Like, something happened on your way trying to meet me. Like, are you okay? And then you pick up with my son call and you say that. Back to square one, I guess. Me, myself, and I. Back to square one. Me, myself, and I. I guess. Accept it and move on. What else can you do? But I found myself most recently in a similar situation. So then I asked myself, you know, this is all part of growth and learning, because it's in that silence. It's in that silence. There ain't nobody there. You know what I mean? You could be feeling all types of feelings of abandonment, betrayal, whatever. They're not great feelings to really, like, sit in. But it makes you question life. It makes you question your purpose. Sometimes I question, is life really for me to be doing this by myself? Because I thought that's not the way life was supposed to work. Because, I mean, in the 80s, when I grew up, community was still heavily strong. I mean, the crack era was starting to destroy it, but I was born in a time where things, I seen it go good to bad, then it just got worse. People just don't relate anymore. I'm such a reciprocal person. That's the way the world is supposed to go around. Reciprocity. You know what I mean? You give and you take. You know, I tell my sons all the time, I said, don't worry about what anybody thinks about you. You know why? Because 9 times out of 10, they're worried about what you're thinking about them. So what's the point? Because they're not worried about you. They're worried about what you think about them. You know what I mean? I think I've been in enough vulnerable situations in my life. I find that I could weave my way through life just communicating, even if it's uncomfortable, especially communicating when you're in a vulnerable situation. You know what I mean? It's not nice to have people know your business, what you're going through, especially when you know you feel bad about it. Oh, I don't want to put this on you. I think when I communicate that, what's going on, people tend to understand. It's just not a good idea, in my opinion.
Avoidance leaves you digging a ditch for you to fall in.
It makes the situation worse. And if I'm already uncomfortable in the uncomfortable situation that I'm in, I don't want to make it worse. So I'm just going to tell you, hey, listen, this is what's going on. And at that point, when I voice to you what's going on, you can decide what you want to do with that information. Hopefully, you would respect it. But if you don't, then that's when it becomes a you problem.
What did I do to deserve you? Don't even know what I did. Been praying on it since a kid. I guess it's just luck if you say so.
So I had some time to reflect again. Some more, once in silence. Yes, I'm currently going through silence. And although it hurts, silence is a good thing. It's a time for me to be able to reflect, to self-evaluate, and it gives me an opportunity to do some shadow work. I think you have to be real courageous to actually do shadow work. Why? Because in order to do shadow work, you do have to face a lot of those vulnerable, uncomfortable feelings. That's the only way you'll grow, right? Like I said earlier, anytime you avoid situations that you know need to be handled, you're doing nothing but digging a ditch for you to fall in. Your own ditch. How's that sound? You like that? As your life goes. That's your life goals if you do that. So during this time of reflection, I've noticed that this is not the second occurrence. This is probably about the third occurrence now that I think about it. See, this all this is occurring, it's like a pattern, you know? You start to notice patterns, like, that's when you gotta sit back and stop and be like, wait, hold up. So when my father passed, right? This is all within 2021 up until now. When my father passed, we had that, you know, that 14-year relationship with that friend that stood me up. I would have never imagined to have done that, especially during such a vulnerable time. And we're supposed to be like this, right? So then, during that time, I make plans to move to a different state. And this is all during, you know, my father's recent passing. I had everything all planned out. You know what I mean? I'm Virgo moon. Like, everything has to be organized. You know what I mean? If there is chaos, there's chaos up here. I will go crazy. Kali Ma, come out. Sekhmet, straight. Like, that's me. You feel me? So there needs to be my order. Okay. So anyway, I was planning to move down to Florida. I had friends. They were a couple that moved down maybe about a year before. And I was planning on coming down there. But I was going to come down the next year. But my father passed. To me, it's like, ain't nothing else left. And the way that certain circumstances was pushing it, I had to leave a lot sooner than what I had planned. So, you know, of course I had my plan A, B, C, D, E, F, G. I asked my friend, hey, I have this lined up. I just have to wait until the house is, you know, like, we're done with the signing and whatnot and everything goes through. Could I stay with you guys? Seemed like they was both for it, right? But I always go through the woman. She said, yeah, so I'm coming. By the time I get out down there, nothing. Anytime you do shadow work, you got to ask yourself questions. You got to dig deep. Why do I feel this way? Is this a trigger? Why is it a trigger? You know, where does this stem from? Or, you know, the question is such. And this is coming from a counselor. I mean, I've gotten my bachelor's in social work and then worked in the field for over 13 years, counseling individuals with drug, alcohol, mental health, you know, working with children, homeless population, juvenile delinquency and such. And that's only just some of the things, you know what I mean, of the populations that, you know, I really, really spent my time serving, you know, but getting back to what we was talking about, I kind of forgot. So let me come back to this clip. 1 second. In the spirit world, they'll call that shadow work. In the lingo, in the terminology of social work, they would call that self-reflection. In psychology, they would call that self-reflection. In Christianity, they would call that waiting on God to hear, waiting to hear on God, waiting, waiting in silence, right? That's talked about much. And what else would it be? Listening to your inner voice, your gut, you know what I mean? I'm trying to give it to you guys in whichever way resonates with you most. But anyway, in doing that shadow work and self-reflection and doing my internal work and waiting on God, listening to my inner voice, you know what I mean? I was able to see that this has been an occurrence, you know, and the only thing that I could get out of it is just people can't communicate.
Let this be just like
this most recent occurrence.
Right face.
Without me going into too much detail.
Bang.
Because this is pretty, like, it's still pretty new, still pretty fresh. It hurts, you know what I mean? And me being vulnerable, I may say some things that you might be like, that probably wasn't a good idea. You know what I mean? But when you're vulnerable and you just survived one hurricane and there's a threat on another and you're trying to find your way out, you know what I mean? Like, at this point, like, I trust this person because of the connection we've had, even though we haven't met just yet. You know what I mean? And I've never asked for anything, you know what I mean? But for him to offer, I was so appreciative for the help that he gave to me and my family at that time. I was in a vulnerable situation. So now this fourth one came as a threat. I'm like, man, I need to plan to get out of here. Like, I swear, if there's another hurricane, I'm leaving. I'm not coming back. Wherever I go, I'm staying. You know what I mean? So I had known this person since 2019. And it felt like when we met, it's been like that meeting was divine. And remember I said in the beginning, when you meet people, y'all realities aren't the same. And even though they may be expressing certain things to you from their world, you know, like, you don't really know what place that's coming from unless you are in a space to discern. You know what I mean? Unless you're in a space to discern, and you have to be in that space. And a lot of times when you're vulnerable, right? I want you to look back and think of vulnerable times in your life where you were in that headspace to discern. It's when people pray. I'm not saying that's this situation. I'm just saying
that all comes with being vulnerable. I mean, there's many different parts of vulnerability I'd like to talk about, even down to the parts of, you know, intimate conversation. But for the sake of this video, that we'll have to hold off for another time. To make a long story short, during this time, I said, there's supposed to be another storm coming. This one's supposed to be really bad. Hurricane Sarah. Man, I'm tired. I am tired. I am so exhausted. This is, come on, it's gonna be the fourth. Debbie, Helene, Milton. Now, Sarah, get out of here. And y'all threatened us with Lisa right before Milton. Like, stop. I'm tired. My resources are depleted. You know, I didn't say all this, but this is how I'm feeling at the time in my vulnerability, you know? And this person said, you know, if you want to get away, I can help you get away for a little bit. You know what I mean? And I was so sure because I'm like, man, we communicate well. Like, we have, like minds and stuff. You know what I mean? But throughout my shadowing, I noticed that a lot of people, they may not have what I expect them to have. It's just them mirroring me. That's what I learned so far. I mean, I pretty much get in the video right now because I figured it out. Y'all learning with me though, even through my old journey. But no, I mean, where I am now, is, you know, after that, listen. You say it, I'm planning now. His reply was, don't threaten me with a good time. I'm like, all right, bet. To me, that means you sure, I'm sure, right? I have no doubt in me. And so I send prices of plane tickets. I don't know what this help means. But to me, being a Virgo moon, I have plan A, B, C, D, E, F, G lined up. You feel me? Like, because of my experiences, where you go to put trust in someone, and as man is fallible, they fail you. You know, can't be stuck. So, but we haven't had this conversation, and I'm trying to have this conversation. You know, give me a call when you get time so we could start to work some plans out and discuss boundaries, all types of stuff, you know? I mean, this is something that we need to discuss, and it's not something that you put off right away because Sarah is on the way. You know, this is not something you avoid or you wait. And this from my experience, we put it on the table now. Okay, I'm gonna call you when I get off of work. There's about 3 hour difference, you know what I mean, between us. Nothing. Okay, well, I respect it. Shit comes up. People have a life, all right? But with this friendship, I'm still expecting some type of communication, like, hey, I know I'm supposed to call you, da da da, but blah, blah, blah. You know what I mean? I'm going to try to blah, blah, blah. Nothing. I'm sending reports. Hey, let me know what's going on. Nothing. Right, but nothing. Hey, are you okay? Like, you disappeared on me. Now I'm starting to be concerned. You good? No, I'm still here. I'm sorry. I sent a voice note. I don't know whether to be mad or be concerned. He said, be mad. Then he says, I'm sorry again. And then he tells me his reason, and he says it's a lame excuse. But I'm like, all right, cool. Like, I respect that. I'm not going to say what his reasoning was because I feel like that reasoning is personal. I would never share that. But Okay, cool. I respect that. Even though you know that you still should have responded and said something to me, you did not. And that's why I'm hurt. Luckily, Sarah ain't coming no more. But damn, you left me stranded, and I could have been left for dead. That's what you really think of me? That's what was in my head. Not like I read that as nonchalant. I'm like, listen, I called you. You said you were gonna call me, you ain't call me back. Over text though. Why do I have to express myself over text? It's kind of crazy. This is the same person who checked up on me, the Hurricane Milton, asked me how I was doing, asked me if I had any food. I told him no, because we've been out of power for like 4 days. And he said, all right, send me your Cash App. And I was so grateful. I was so grateful. And honestly, at that point, like, this is the first type of gesture I've ever had from him. So after all these years, I was like, that's how you feel about me? Aw. Like, I love you too, friend. You know what I mean? This person does say that I love you, Ijada. You know, I always was skeptical, like, are you just saying it for fun? Or, like, because I tell my friends that I love them. I tell them all the time. So I'm like, oh, okay, I love you too. You left me all right. No way out. What happened, son? You're texting me. You could call me now. I'm opening up the floor for you to speak. Nothing. All right. See, I wanted to know what the plans was. I even put it out there, listen, if you had a change of heart, if you spoke too fast, if something came up, let me know. I just need to know what I'm doing. Because she's on the way. And this is not something that I can lollygag on. So, like, with that much respect, knowing that I'm trying to plan for evacuations, like, luckily I don't keep all my eggs in one basket. You know what I mean? But that's crazy. It's like the principle. See, I've had times where I've helped people. I've let people move in with me. If I've had a change of heart, I've sat on it. I've thought about it. I was going to say it. I spoke to him about it. I communicated it, right? I have another friend, right, whom I've known since for about 6 years. And we're very, like, our synergy is, like, real good, especially when it comes to creating and shit, right? So we was planning. We was planning to do some business in a particular spot. And we started planning, you know, we bouncing ideas, you know, our goals, how we're going to meet those, the milestones to get there, we researching and stuff, right? Right? And something said, and I get triggered. And I'm like, whoa, if that's the case, like, I was thinking playing something else, and I thought we was on the same page, but if that's the case, now my heart is racing. I don't know about this. See, but the difference is that I told him my fear and how I felt, and we spoke about it. It's that simple. I didn't lead him on. Plan the whole goddamn trip, get to the trip and shit, and then fucking leave him stranded. That's fucked up. Those are my experiences. And so when I'm communicating with these people, and they're usually like friends for a really long time, I cherish these friendships. But then I notice that when I need them, you know, then all of a sudden, the communication isn't there. Is this superficial? Now that I'm like putting all these different patterns together of these familiar spirits that I'm running into. Later on down the line, I always find out, and it always comes out one way or another, that they got some shit going on with them. Like, I got shit going on with me, but they ain't dealing with it either. And so because they're not dealing with their own shit, I even find out that I put myself out there to be a friend to you, a listening ear. I'm here if you need me. Some choose not to utilize me for those types of things. Maybe they feel like they're getting too vulnerable if they do that. But I'm being vulnerable with you. And we've been friends this long. If you don't know me by now, then baby, you will never, ever, ever know me. By now, it always comes out later that there's some type of insecurity. You know what I mean? Like, I get it. I got my own shit, too. Only difference is I'll tell you what it is. I'll tell you what my insecurity is. I don't fucking care. But I can't expect, because I'm open and vulnerable with people and authentically me, for them to be the same. I can't expect that. So, knowing that, hopefully shit like that don't happen again, because you know what I mean? We gonna rebuke that right now, as you would say, some would say. We gonna return that shit to sender, as others would say. That's not about to fucking happen. Because we stopped that right now. Enough is a fucking enough. I'm just not the type of person. Like, I can't do the surface, superficial shit. Like, I just can't. And I'm tired of being mirrored. And I understand sometimes triggers come up and you're like, whoa, this is new to me. You know what I mean? And you might have to sit back and like really digest this shit before you can even talk about it. I understand that. But then say that. Then I respect that, give you time to be able to process it. And then when you're ready to come talk, I'm right here. It's that simple. Maybe I value friendships too much. But you know what? I can take out some good things, because this specific opportunity has shown me the familiar spirits within these patterns that I'm running into. And now that I know what it looks like, it's going to be easier for me to avoid. Because now I know what that shit feel like. I know what it looks like. I recognize what the fuck it is. It snuck up on me 3 times. You know what I mean? Most recently. But now I see you, peekaboo ass bitch. And I'm not saying that like to regarding anyone specifically. I'm just saying in the spirit realm, I see you, bitch. I see you.
Let this be just like smack you right in the face. Like, bang, bang, bang. So far, deep down the rabbit hole. Guess who's deep and vulnerable? Search so hard like Dagnum. We eat so much like cannibals. Here's for trophies, dead by. Corrupt individuals, let fly.